If you'd like to see this video again or others like it, go to our website, homeworkhotline.org, and click on videos. For the past couple weeks on Hotline, we've been asking you guys to send us questions about Native Americans. And now are some of the questions that you want answered. Our first question comes from Ben in New York City. He wants to know if Native Americans still live on reservations.
It's both yes and no. It's really a choice. When people first started going onto reservations, they were forced to live on reservations. And the government, using the army and other resources, forced Native Americans to live on land that was specifically set aside for them. They weren't allowed to leave. They weren't allowed to make a livelihood off of the reservation, move to a city or something like that. But today, people have the choice of where they want to live. So I live here in the Rochester area, but I have lots of family that still lives on the Onondaga Reservation, and I can go there whenever I want, or I could leave there whenever I want.
Good. All right, our next question comes from Alex in New York City, and he wants to know if any Native American nation has tried to join the United Nations.
Oh, this is an excellent, excellent question, because one thing about Native Americans that sometimes people forget is that there are more than 500 different tribes or nations of Native Americans in the United States today.
Wow.
So when we think about Native Americans, sometimes they're all grouped together, like we're all the same. But that's not true. At Onondaga, we are different even than the Cayugas or the Oneidas who lived right next door to us.
Right.
So each of these tribes is different in their own way. We were talking about wampum belts. This is something that we find only among Haudenosaunee. We don't find this if we went to a tribe like the Lakotas out on the plains or the Navajos out in the desert. They just don't have things from the ocean like we did,
right,
that we traded for. So today, many people still live on reservations, but many people live off of reservations. In fact, in the United States, the place where there are the most Native Americans is New York City.
Really?
Oh,
because
wow,
that's where there's the most people.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Beth from Syracuse, New York wants to know, what's the most difficult tradition to hold on to for Native Americans?
Well, I think that answer would be different for each Native American there is in the whole United States. Right now, there are about 4.1 million Native Americans, according to the last United States census. So for each person, it's a little bit different. When people look at me when I'm dressed like this in my modern clothes, or they see me doing modern things, teaching, using smart boards, things like that, and they see that I have lighter skin or that I don't have long hair like people did a long time ago, they sometimes wonder if I'm really Native American. And I am.
Right.
Because I was born this way. And everyone in my family is Native American. So for me, sometimes it's hard just to be accepted as a Native American. But when people see me in my regalia or traditional clothing, right away they know I am Native American. But it's not those clothes that make me Native American. It's the beliefs and traditions that we still follow. For other people that live maybe in rural areas, it's easier for them to hold on to their language because they only speak their language where they live. Whereas those of us that live in cities, we speak English. So that's harder for us to hold on to. So it's different for each person.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, Tom from Rochester, New York asks, is it difficult to be a part of two nations? Is it hard to follow the Native American culture and laws and follow the United States laws and traditions at the same time?
This is a exceptional question, and Tom should be very proud of himself for asking this question. The answer to that is absolutely yes, it's very hard. When I was here the last time, I was wearing a wampum belt, different from this one,
right,
that we call the two-row wampum, that I had as part of my regalia. And that wampum belt talks about traveling in two rivers, one that we said was for the European people and all the things that they brought here. It was really a treaty we made with the Dutch people. So we talked about their language and their religion and their government and their donuts, because they brought donuts here. And we said they could have all those things. And in our river, for the Haudenosaunee, we would have our language, our religion, our government, our corn soup, things like that, things that we eat. But we also said that we could step over from one river to the other and borrow things from the other group, but that we should hang on to the things from our own river as well. So it's very difficult to live in the 21st century and still speak our language or practice our religion, especially if I have to go and live far away from my reservation, because we don't have our religion anyplace except on my reservation. So that is hard for me to practice unless I travel there every single time there is a ceremony. So again, it's hard to do some of those traditional things, but at the same time, I like electricity and I like driving my car and I like all those things too.
Sure.
So the video we just watched talked about lacrosse and how it has a close tie to the Native Americans. Can you explain some of that?
Well, it's not just a close tie. We invented that game. So it's really part of who we are. We heard in the video that the guys in the video were saying they had sticks when they were 2 or 3 or 5 years old. And absolutely, my nephews, who are 6-year-olds right now, all play lacrosse, and they have their own sticks. They have their own wooden sticks, the traditional sticks we've been using for hundreds of years. I wish I had brought my wooden stick with me here today to show everybody, but I just left it at home so that I could play with my daughter over the weekend. But that game is very important to us. That game is so important to us, we say it was invented at the time that the whole world was invented. It's actually part of our creation story. So we continue to play that today. It still has the same meaning, like we heard in the video, that it's about respect, it's about responsibility, it's about sportsmanship, and all of those values are still very important to us.
Cool. Very good. Cool.